We need to hook some 100-pounders.
Yeah.
The Big Island is the premier spot for kayak fishing in the world. These super big mountains create really steep drop-offs in the water.
There it is, right there.
And it allows the big fish to come in and hit up the ledges. And that's where you go and drop your line to hook the big ones.
All right, I'm gonna make my first drop here and see what we can conjure up.
Fishermen like Andy and Rob use live bait to attract the 100-pound tuna, ono, and mahi-mahi that can bring them the big bucks.
Where are you? Where are you? Oh, I'm on!
Doing good, man. Proud of you. How you feeling? Two more.
On the first morning of peak season, an old school kayaker is putting a newcomer through his paces. Veteran Boogie D and Jason Valle start their day by running rocks. This traditional Hawaiian workout builds the strength needed to reel in 100-pound monster fish.
I love kayak fishing because I love the ocean. It's not all about the money, it's my soul. The adrenaline that you get fishing on a kayak is so much more extreme than on a boat. When you're right on the water with them and they're literally like right in your lap, it feels more like hand-to-hand combat.
Good run, Jason, that's a long one.
Boogie is one of the oldest kayak fishermen on Oahu. But after 20 years of battling monster fish, he's transitioning from hunter to teacher.
That was a long bombing run on that last one. Thank you.
Jason Valle, his uncle who passed away in a car accident was one of my best friends.
You're frustrating out there.
I often look at Jason and I see my best friend. I'm deeply invested in Jason. I want to see him develop and mature into the best fisherman he can be.
I'm pretty new to kayak fishing. I feel more comfortable in the water than on land, you know, from surfing to diving. It really means the world to me to be able to learn from somebody experienced as Boogie.
This season, Boogie is going to put Jason through the mill, molding him into an expert who can land 100-pound tuna and ono like a master.
Man, what a beautiful day. This looks like it's going to be a good day to hit the water, man.
Looks like a nice day to go body surfing instead of fishing.
Today, Boogie's introducing Jason to one of his closely guarded secrets, Kaina Point.
Kaina Point is one of our favorite fishing grounds. We know there's good fishing there, but we also know there's heavy danger out there. Two currents come together and rip off the island.
I know a lot of guys got their asses kicked on a boat going around that thing.
Lined with steep cliffs, there's no road access to Kaina Point, forcing Boogie and Jason to paddle over 4 miles to these remote waters.
Our biggest recipe for disaster is gonna be like that last half a mile from the point. So it's very important today that we stay close. Get this party started, dude. I'm excited.
Nervous when I dive. Having a healthy amount of fear is exactly what keeps me alive. It reminds me that I am so small and so humbled in this big ocean. And I think the people that forget that are the ones that wind up in dangerous situations all the time.
On Oahu, not all kayak fishermen make their living above the waves. Kimmy Werner takes the fight directly to the fish.
I am a spear fisher woman, and I spear fish by free diving. So I don't use any scuba tanks or, you know, anything to help me breathe. I just hold my breath, dive down, look for fish, and if I can find them, then I try and shoot them in the head.
Kimmy's method is direct and extremely dangerous. Diving to depths of more than 150 feet, she uses just her senses and her spear to track and catch the fish. But today, she's hunting the one valuable creature that renders her spear gun useless.
Octopus in Hawaiian, the name is he'e. Oftentimes, we call it by the Japanese name, which is taco. It is a staple of food here. I know that can seem weird to a lot of people. Octopus might not look appetizing, but it's absolutely delicious. The hardest part about taco hunting is finding the taco. Hopefully, I'll be able to find some out there.
Like the ancient Hawaiians that used six-foot bamboo spears to hunt down fish, Kimmy's turning to the ocean as her primary source of food.
I go hunting and I get fish, and that's what I eat to survive. It's so wonderful to go into the ocean with a simple spear and come home with dinner. You have just a one-track mind. You really just can't let anything break your focus.
Kimmy can hold her breath for up to 4 minutes. Any longer, and she faces the biggest risk in freediving.
There's something very common in freediving that is called shallow water blackout. It's more dangerous than currents, it's more dangerous than sharks. Shallow water blackout is basically from holding your breath too long and you black out underwater. And if there's nobody there to help you, to save you, you're dead.